Hi, my name's Lynette Reese. I'm here at Mouser Electronics, and I'm also here to do an unboxing of the STM32 Nucleo. So it's a pretty simple box here, but it's a rather simple package with a single card and a location to go to get your information about the Nucleo. The STM32 Nucleo is Arduino compatible, and it has some features that are rather thoughtful with regard to the typical annoyances that you might see in real life hardware debugging. When you get one of these boards, you find that you'll need a mini USB cable. That's the B side that has the larger, but not the largest, end to it. And that does not come in the box, so you'll have to get that. So let's do a quick rundown of some of the features. This STM32 Nucleo is really open source hardware. So stuff like example software and free software libraries, GCC tools, are all available. And the STM32 Nucleo is compatible with the same shields as the Arduino Uno Rev3. The STM32 Nucleo can be powered by USB or by external pins that give you 7 to 12 volts DC, and it can go up to 800 milliamps max on that power supply. So all the I/O of the MCU is brought out to these male pins that project from either side of the board, and that is all of the I/O. It comes with a free in-circuit debugger and programmer for the STM32 MCUs, and that's not just those that populate the Nucleo board. So you could buy this board just for the debugger. There's no separate probe then to purchase for these STM32 Nucleos, and you can also use the this is where the USB port is for debugging. And application-wise, this supports USB mass storage, drag and drop programming, and virtual serial communication through the USB port via emulation. There are 6 analog inputs and 16 digital I/O that go out to the Arduino headers. There's a couple of user-defined LEDs, and a user button, and there's a reset button, and also there's an external reset pin. So let's talk some more about the MCU. The boards include a series of ARM Cortex-M-based MCUs on, like I said, nearly identical platforms. Obviously, their Arduino portion is identical, and these other pins on the outside that protrude from both sides, those are also, again, nearly identical. At least the I/O is identical. So that makes these boards quite scalable as you go up the line of Cortex-M ARM MCUs, ARM-based MCUs. So at the time of release here, with these 4 different boards running different MCUs, all 32-bit wide RISC cores at clock speeds of 32 megahertz, 48 megahertz, 72, and 84 megahertz. And in this particular board, the STM32 F103 Nucleo is a particular board that I have in my hand right now. That runs at 72 megahertz. This is a low-power MCU with sleep, stop, and standby modes that can support up to 9 communication interfaces. Of course, we've got USB, but there's also USART, I2C, SPI, and it can even support CAN. So props to STMicroelectronics for launching a very practical, scalable, accessorizable, and accessible dollar-wise family of boards. The STM32 Nucleo encourages off-the-beaten-path experimentation. Kudos, ST.